Our next guest has revised down his forecast for real growth in the Philippine construction industry due to the COVID-19 pandemic. With us now for more is James Su, infrastructure analyst at Fitch Solutions in Singapore. Good to see you, James. Welcome back to the program.
Morning.
Yeah, so you're now forecasting construction to slow to 3.6% year on year in real terms, coming from the previous forecast of 5.8%. What was the key driver for that downward revision?
Okay, so I guess the key driver for the downward revision is that there's an extension to the enhanced community quarantine. So right now it's in place until May the 15th. And we can see that the entire Luzon is still, most parts of Luzon is still under lockdown. And the ECQ has even been extended to areas outside of Luzon. So this includes highly populated areas such as Cebu and Davao City. And as we all know that these highly populated areas is where most of the construction activity is taking place. So that's why we are revising down our forecast. And also we can see that the building sector, Luzon is heavily exposed to the building sector. So you can see that because Luzon is under lockdown, a big portion of construction activity is lost there.
Yeah, but there are some areas that are already moving down to a so-called general community quarantine. Won't those areas matter in terms of the building sector, that they could probably offset the losses sustained because of the extension of the enhanced community quarantine in most parts?
Certainly, but I don't think the offset will be that great because bulk of the construction activity is still taking place in highly populated areas, especially in the Luzon area where the National Capital Region is located. So not only building sector is affected, the infrastructure sector is affected as well. So if you were to take a look at the Build flagship projects list, most of the projects are located in Luzon. And if you were to delve even further into it, a lot of projects are taking place in the National Capital Region. So these projects include things like the North-South Commuter Railway, so on and so forth. So that is why we think that there will be a larger impact on overall construction activity in the Philippines. And that is why we've moved on to make a downward revision of our growth forecasts.
Now talk to us about the infrastructure build, because you're still seeing the infrastructure sector outperforming the overall construction sector. Isn't infrastructure going to be playing catch-up just the same?
It will play catch-up. That's why we think that growth versus 2019 will be significantly slower. But we still think it will outperform the overall construction sector as well as the overall economy. So for infrastructure, we have to see that the government is prioritizing infrastructure spending. But we only think that construction activity will only resume only when the pandemic situation gets better. So our current assumption right now is for this to occur sometime in the second half of the year. But we have to take note that the situation is extremely fluid. Anything can happen. And if the situation does not get better by then, we will put pressure on our forecast yet again.
Yeah, but it does help that we got a pledge from the government that infrastructure build is going to remain as one of the key priorities. But to what extent will that be dependent on whether more money could be diverted to fighting COVID-19? Already 30 billion pesos from the Public Works Department had been redirected.
Exactly. So the Department of Public Works and Highways, as well as the Department of Transportation, has received a boost in the budget for fiscal year 2020. But we could see more of these budgets get reallocated away from these two departments, which means that some projects will suffer funding issues in 2020 away if the pandemic situation does not improve over the next half of the year. So there's always a risk here, and that's something that we are watching closely.
Okay, well, keep us up to speed if those revisions come, if and when they do. Stay safe.
Sure,
thanks for that, James. James Su of Fitch Solutions in Singapore.